You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. In 2022, the average asking rent for retail shops in Taipei's Zhongshan Business District was around NT$15,623 per paying, the highest in Taipei City.
The popularity of Taipei City's Zhongshan Business District has risen in recent years. It is very popular among young people, and the average asking rent for retail shops in the area are trending up.
很多就是好看的店，就是那种文青风的店，是那种小女生很喜欢来的地方。以前都逛过了，对，就这边比较多，多新的店。小店的关系处起来，单价比较高。那主要因为商圈的特色，因为它比较偏向文青属性，那里面有一些百货公司，那整个商圈对于年轻人来讲，那购物的一个
CP 值很高。 Experts pointed out that Zhongshan Business District, which is close to the MRT, has department stores nearby. There are many specialty shops in the alleys, which are very attractive for single product consumption. According to last year's real price lease, a small storefront in the Zhongshan Business District was leased for NT$125,000 per month in January last year, which translates to a unit price of NT$15,623 per ping. Taipei's East District, which was often led shop rents in Taipei, ranked second in 2022. Data shows that Taipei's spending power is gradually shifting among districts. The formerly bustling East District is no longer full of shops, but instead full of rental advertisements.
可能现在就是一个触底，那可能呈现一个缓步复苏的这样一个状况，但是要回到过去这种单品2万块。
Ximending District is struggling to recover after the epidemic, which has severely damaged business from international tourists. It may not be easy to restore to pre-epidemic levels in the short term.
A 75-year-old woman surnamed Lee recently got caught using counterfeit U.S. currency in exchange for real NT dollars at a bank in Taipei City. Police investigation showed that it was not her first attempt, and Lee and another woman have both been charged by the police.
The woman took out a thick stack of U.S. $100 bills and wanted to exchange it all into NT dollars at the bank. The teller took the money but recognized it was fake soon enough. The counterfeit U.S. $100 bill is almost identical to the real $100 bill. A 75-year-old woman surnamed Lee tried exchanging fake U.S. banknotes for NT dollars at a bank in Taipei City on the 13th. She said to the police she was unaware of its inauthenticity. The bank teller told the police that the records show that Ms. Lee had successfully fooled the teller and exchanged fake cash for real money twice at the end of 2022. It was harder for the teller to detect since she was using counterfeit U.S. currency banknotes of an older design.
要叫我收这些旧版的货币，我们自己本身就要这些辨识的能力，不然的话不小心收到这种超级美钞的话，超级伪钞的话是蛮累的。用透光检视的时候，可以在钞券的右侧部分可以看到那个富兰克林的水印。
Besides checking for watermarks and security thread with microprinting, another way to check to see if a bill is authentic is to check for color-shifting ink on the number in the lower right corner. Police would like to encourage the public to use the latest printed U.S. currency since the new designs are more difficult to counterfeit.
After much speculation, Premier Susan Chang will unveil the changes in the executive yuan after lawmakers finalize the general budget.
The executive yuan held its last meeting on the 19th before the Lunar New Year holiday begins. DPP legislators from the Taiwan Normal Country Promotion Association faction held a press conference earlier, calling for a younger, more diverse and democratic cabinet team. They suggested appointing councillors and city or county mayors as cabinet members.
三分之一以上由担任过立委或者是县市长者来担任新的内阁组成。 应该有这样接地气政府的一个思考。
The Taiwan Normal Country Promotion Association seemed to be vouching for former Keelung City Mayor Lin Youchang. Rumor has it that Lin will become the new Minister of the Interior. Economic Affairs Minister Wang Meihua and Minister of Transportation and Communications Wang Guocai will likely stay put. Former Vice President Chen Jianren has been set to take over Su as Premier, but Chen said he was not aware of such a development. There is also talk of the cabinet reshuffle happening after the New Year holiday instead. However, lawmakers still failed to come to a consensus on the surplus tax rebate legislative regulations before the final vote on the 19th. The KMT caucus held a press conference claiming that the DPP caucus is purposely delaying the process by not agreeing on changing the payment to NT$10,000. Legislative Yuan President Yeo Shi-kun is asking lawmakers from both sides to each take a step back. Premier Su and related cabinet members will report to the Legislative Yuan on the reshuffle after voting on the central government budget for 2023 is done.
I will now bring some top stories from around the nation. Tainan City is now also giving out NT$10,000 in rewards to citizens who are willing to assist the traffic police by offering their onboard or data recorded video. The Taoyuan Airport is packed. Public health experts are concerned that the new variants can cause another outbreak after the holiday. The Climate Change Response Act passed its third reading on the 11th and established a goal of reaching net zero carbon emissions in Taiwan by 2050. Several employees of the National Health Insurance Administration are suspected of leaking people's personal information. Initial reports indicated that there is no evidence of a data breach.
The National Health Insurance Administration revealed that internal staff are suspected of leaking personal information to the public and other intelligence agencies for 13 years. A few days ago, the media disclosed that the investigation found that the underwriting division conducted 130,000 inquiries about people's insurance information. No evidence of a data breach has been found from the administration's investigation.
谢信同仁在1007年的8月3号到8月8号期间，有大量查询，大约10万多笔的个人资讯。目前查有公务依据，初步认为符合个资法第15条第一款的执行法定职务必要范围内的查询。
The NHIA said Shea retrieved the data for statistical analysis to evaluate the implementation of changes to the monthly retirement annuity for retired civil servants in July 2018. If retired civil servants changed from the first category of dependents to insurer to using the second and third categories of professional trade unions or agricultural and fishery associations, how much the NHIA's insurance premiums would be affected.
此项调阅目前是查有相关公务的办理依据，以及也有分析统计的结果可以佐证，并不是刻意针对特定的国安机敏人员的个资进行查调。据目前的调查，并无该笔资料由遭人以USB存取析出的 log 记录。
The employee surnamed Lee, who has been in charge of the underwriting business for more than 10 years, is still under investigation. He inquired about more than 133,000 and 35,000 records, respectively, during his period of accessibility.
And now some international news of the day. The three main figures in Ukraine's interior ministry have been killed in a helicopter crash beside a nursery in an eastern suburb of the capital, Kyiv. A total of 14 people died in this accident. New Zealand's Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern announced that she would step down from her role in early February. Ardern said it had been a tough 5.5 years and that she was only human and needed to step aside. Florida manatees, the gentle sea mammals known as sea cows are dying in Florida at an alarming rate, mostly of starvation. The Asian Winter League was suspended for 3 years due to the epidemic, and after the 2022 CPBL season, several young CPBL players went to the Australian Baseball League to extend their season. And among them, Rakuten Monkeys' 24-year-old pitcher returned to Taiwan yesterday.
Rakuten Monkeys pitcher Wen Weijun returned to Taiwan on the 18th. He is very tanned after playing in the Australian Baseball League after the 2022 CPBL season. The sun shines every day right now in the Southern Hemisphere. He played 9 games for the Auckland Tuatara, logging 6 starts, 4 wins and 1 loss, with an ERA of 3.48. Wen believes he still has room for improvement, but his psychological state has improved a lot.
大家都说运动员需要很强大的心理素质，那心理素质就是要从场上去磨练，然后跟平常私底下的生活去尝试去问，就是不要怕失败。
Wen learned about his own shortcomings from the games and from players from different countries and levels. And Huang from CTBC Brothers, Lin Ziwei and Lin Huishen also played for Auckland Tuatara. Not only do the teammates support each other, but Wen also learned a lot from Lin.
去告诉你可能今天你不足的地方在哪，然后我们也可以彼此的去交流，就是去讨论、去沟通。对，我们现在应该要做什么，而不是
Wen underwent 2 elbow bone spur removal operations in the past. He only returned to the first team in August 2022. He will return to Rakuten Monkeys after the Lunar New Year break.
Thanks for watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. We'll see you tomorrow.